Hello, we're backstage and I'm with Russell Kane. I'm really excited.
Hello, not as excited as me. God, I'm on the Imodium. Fourth pill. I'm still not kicking in though. It's a big old gig. Such a historic venue. The Palladium for a comedian has got so many associations stretching back through history. Many of us have done the Royal Variety, which is a much, much harder gig than tonight, which is a lovely gig. But still, you've got associations of like walking past like last year's X Factor winner as Harry Styles walked by. You're sort of wheeled out to tell jokes no one listens to.
Do you get nervous at gigs still?
What do you think? Do I look together to you?
I'm good.
Now, I'm on stage in 15 minutes. I'm an incredibly nervous performer.
Yeah.
And I thought when I started that the nerves would go, but I've just sort of worked her way to put them in the act. That's all that's happened.
Yeah.
Branding.
I had a few questions for you.
Yep.
Firstly, we have to get the Nick Grimshaw question out of the way with.
It will be mentioned tonight on stage because you get it so often.
So you get mistaken for him a lot.
All the time,
right.
Every gig. It will happen tonight. It will happen at stage door. The only reason it hasn't happened now is because I got out of my car and straight into the theatre. It happens every day.
Does he get it as well? Have you guys discussed
it? Not that he'll admit.
Okay.
Not that he'll admit. Obviously, for me, it's good because it's funny, but for him, it's a downgrade.
And you were telling me, you said, I've got to rush tonight.
Yeah.
Because you've got to get back to watch something. Is that right?
Yeah, I'm going to want to get home for Celebrity on Plus One.
So you love I'm a Celebrity,
yes,
don't
of course,
you?
I'm a telly addict. Yeah. What it is, I'm really knackered, I'm really busy, I'm doing loads of stuff, and I almost said no to this. And then I looked at the lineup, and I looked at the cause, and everyone knows someone is affected by this issue.
Yeah.
And I thought, I'll do it if I can go on first, thinking there's no way they say yes. They said yes. I was like, oh, damn it. So now I've got to go on first. Here we go.
And then they said, you've got to do a stupid interview with me, and you're like, oh, great.
No, then it was all worth it.
Oh, love him. So I'm a Celebrity. Who are you enjoying in I'm a Celebrity?
I think Toff.
Okay.
I really like the hot ET,
that's
Georgia,
Joel Dominic
called
it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Toff.
Why do you
She's like
her?
That. He's just so posh. It's almost like there's something wrong with her. It's like it's so posh. I've got osteoporosis from it. Like her. She's got osteoporosis.
And there's always a kind of crazy person who has a meltdown. Who's that going to be this year?
It could be Ian Lee, you know.
Do you think so?
Well, he's already started, didn't he?
Yeah.
Because he didn't complete his task. He went to cry in his room for a bit.
Yeah.
And then he came in to covering up. I know what he's doing because he's a bit shy and socially awkward like we can all be. He came in sort of mock arrogant and it was taken the wrong way. So yeah. I think there could be a potential meltdown there.
And you also, I know that you watch Strictly, talking of reality shows
at
home,
I was just watching it in my dressing room, but I was pretending I was watching a documentary about Palestine and someone walked in. And I was like, it's so bad. It's so bad about the settlements.
Was it Alan Carr? Oh, let's have a look, love.
Someone walked in after I'd been pretending I was watching a heavy doc, but I wasn't. So I haven't seen this week's.
Okay.
So don't spoil it. But
I happen to know your little girl is a fan of one of the contestants.
Unbelievable.
Isn't she?
She's obsessed with Debbie. She's two. She's obsessed with Debbie McGee. She cries. She wakes up, cries to Debbie McGee. I'm trying to raise her without too much telly because she's only two, but she's obsessed with Debbie McGee and Mr. Tumble.
I've seen a video of her saying, Debbie McGee.
I was hoping for like Charlotte Bronte or Jane Austen, but it's Mr. Tumble and Debbie McGee.
You've got Paul Daniels' widow. There you go.
I know.
I have a quick thing to do before you go on and do your thing.
You might want
to
stop filming.
You need to. Can you take that?
Yeah.
This is terrible. This is my naughty clutch.
I knew it. I bloody knew it.
And
that's just how it started last time. The last thing I remember, I woke up in a transit.
Such a lie. You need to pick a question out of my naughty clutch.
Okay.
And you can answer it. I think you might have time for two, but
what
let's see how
it
goes.
I mean, if you want to know, I'm on stage in 10 minutes. This is real gross.
So here's the first question from my naughty clutch. Russell Kane is going to answer it. Read it out.
What was the last WhatsApp message you sent? It was a picture to my boys group. Thank God it's one I can share. Most men have a boys group where if it was seen, their relationships would be over. But it's not going to be funny when I describe it. It's someone in a European flag shaking someone with a Union Jack around them, and the guy with the Union Jack cutting his own arm off and going, "See, I've won."
I like that. It was a political serious.
I was trying to get the group because the last thing was a Staffordshire Bull Terrier penetrating a short woman. So I was just trying to up the standard of the group. But
right, last one before you go on stage.
Dog porn is better than satire on a boys' group. We all know it.
That's a nice takeaway message for the night.
It's so bad about Brexit, but look at that dog. He's really loving it.
Okay.
You can't tell me the dog's being abused in that video.
Read the next
When
question.
Was the last time you accidentally stole something? Probably when I stole some girl's heart at a show, when I didn't mean to. No, It would be something from a dressing room.
Oh,
in fact,
do you think so?
I know exactly what it is.
When was it?
From the last gig, one of the last tour dates I did in the summer. I'm such a nerd. I turn up with my self-plunging cafetiere mug and my ice bag with my packed lunch in it.
Yeah.
And there was there was an ice pack in the freezer at the venue, and I may have topped up my ice pack for the journey. I had an egg mayonnaise
salad.
Call
the police.
I stole an ice pack from a theatre to keep my egg mayonnaise salad.
You know, that I like that because it's a good follow-up to I Kissed a Girl and I Liked It. I stole an ice pack from a theatre.